In this lecture, we will see together how to set up the application, how to set up Andromic. So first of all, you should go to the resources link or repository, which are provided in the next two lectures, which are lecture 6 and 7, backend resources and front-end resources. So first of all, we need to start with the backend setup, and already everything is described in the README. And I'll just explain to you much better. So the project, first of all, is developed using Java and Spring Boot framework. And to run the application, first you need to clone. And to clone the application, you only click here, and whether you get the HTTP or the SSH link, and then just you copy paste it in your terminal. Next, you need to import the project using your preferred IDE. Personally, I recommend using IntelliJ Community version. Okay, it's the free version, but it's completely sufficient for our development. Then update the project, and build the dependencies using, for example, the command line maven clean install minus upper u. Or you just on your IntelliJ on the Maven section on the right, you just click update Maven dependencies, and it's gonna be all right. Once updating or once building the project, go and check the target folder that it contains the jar file for the application, and it contains correctly the swagger.json file, because it's gonna be needed for the front-end application. And then just open the to-do application.java and run it using the green play button or whatever IDE you use, just run the application. Once the backend application is up and running and the swagger JSON file and the jar file are generated, you can go and check and also set up the front-end application, which I provided already the link here. So I will click and go to the front-end application and explain what needs to be done in order to run it. So first of all, the project is created or generated using the Angular CLI version 9.0.4. I didn't choose the version 10 because it's not yet stable, because I tried it, but I faced many issues. So that's why I downgraded to the Angular 9. So first of all, as mentioned here, you need to clone the backend project, so this part should be already done. And now follow the instruction to run correctly the backend project and generate the swagger JSON file, the REST API documentation, and so on and so forth. So here, in the package.json file in the line 14, which is here, on the line 14, here you need to provide your own path, because here I just because the application or the jar files are not hosted on a virtual machine or on a server online, so I'm using my absolute path for this. So you just go and fetch your generated jar file and just copy paste the absolute path here and also here, the JSON and the jar file path. So what comes next? Actually, there are two different options to run the application. The first one, the option one, is first command we need to run is npm install to update and install all the dependencies and libraries. Then run the command npm run todo API. This command will generate all the services or all the needed services for the application. I already uploaded everything with my generated services, but if you want to do it yourself or for future different projects, so this is the way to do it. And also you can follow the example here in the package.json, which will be explained in further lectures. So then just run the ng-serve and then navigate to the localhost on the 4200 port/login, and the app will automatically reload if any changes if you change anything or any resource file. So this is the first option. The second option is you need first of all to run the npm install command line. So as I said, to install and update all the dependencies and libraries. And then it's for one simple and one single command, just run npm run start double point local, and then navigate to this address. So I will just explain really quick this command line. So this command will, which is this one, and it will group the npm run to do API and the ng-serve both together. So once everything is correctly cloned and correctly built, the application should be running correctly.